mRNA has many strengths for various types of therapy compared to DNA and viral approaches. One of the chief ones are it's transient, so you get short-term protein production. If you're doing gene editing, that's ideal. It's also very efficient, very high transfection efficiency, which means a large number of cells are treated with each injection. Some of the advantages of mRNA therapy for the treatment of rare diseases are the treatments are in vivo. What that means is you don't take cells out of a person. You inject RNA LNPs. That means this treatment can be given anywhere in the world without extensive, complicated hospital facilities. Certainly, the COVID pandemic boosted and accelerated the development of mRNA therapies. They were already in clinical trials beforehand, but COVID gave it to billions of people and awakened the world to RNA's potential. For neuromuscular diseases, the research is preclinical, which means it's on animal models. But the advantages are it's easier to target large amounts of muscle with RNA LNPs, giving the hope that a single or very few treatments will be able to fix the genetic disorder and potentially cure neuromuscular diseases. RNA has the potential to be a revolution for many different types of diseases. It's already been used for liver genetic therapy in people with a deadly form of amyloidosis, and it's in over 300 clinical trials for a variety of diseases. I see it as the treatment of the future. Certainly, the AFM telethon is I think, the first and the major driver of neuromuscular disease research. They hold fantastic conferences that bring in 1,000 people to talk about therapies, to collaborate and develop new therapies that will turn into treatments for the patients. I enjoy these kind of conferences because they bring me and allow me to talk to experts in many different fields. So I go to bone therapy conferences, I go to neuromuscular conferences, I go to lymphoma conferences to be able to talk to the experts and set up collaborations and develop new treatment approaches.